What's good, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another video, man. So today we are reacting to Tupac featuring Biggie Smalls, B.I.G. Running, Dying to Live for the very first time. So if you got any other videos you're gonna react to, man, comment them down below. I'll definitely get to them. But let's get right into it though. In 3, 2, 1, bow.
Between you and Biggie, it was like who rules the nigga kingdom and shit, basically. You know what I'm saying? I was like, this is like a fucking election. It's an election.
It is that
shit. You know what I'm saying?
Me and Biggie's situation is smaller than that. Me and Biggie's situation is like
that's only gonna black male shot like when he's very
shot
Bro, let me know, did they actually do this song together, or did niggas take his verse and then take Biggie Smalls' verse and put it in a song saying, oh, they did the song? You know what I'm saying? Because you know motherfuckers be capping. They be like, yeah, Biggie and Tupac did a song, knowing they ain't, you know what I'm saying, how like Drake did a song with Michael Jackson, but Drake had bought Michael Jackson's music and put it on his album. You feel me? So was it like that? Let me know, because I honestly don't know. But I like how it sounded so far, though. It's real melodic.
Check it, I grew up a fucking screw up. Got introduced to the game, got an ounce of fucking blood. Chopping rocks overnight. The nigga Biggie Smalls trying to turn into the black Frank White. We had the no dreads to change our description. Two cops is on the milk box missing. Show they toes, you know they got stepped on. A fist full of bullets.
See, I never heard Biggie like this though. This is different to me. I've never heard Biggie like this. We all know like the, well, me personally, I can't speak for y'all. I can't speak for nobody. But I know all of like Biggie's, you know, mainstream stuff. I know all of Biggie's big shit, the shit that they always promote. You know what I'm saying? They don't promote shit like this. I never even knew they had a song together. I never knew Biggie even rap like this. You feel me? I saw his freestyles. Everybody saw his freestyle, and you know, in Bed-Stuy, Brooklyn, whatever. Everybody saw his freestyles. You know what I'm saying? But I never heard him flow like this. Like this right here is tough. I got listed some more, man. I got listed some more.
Chest full of tap on, run from the police, picture that. Nigga, I'm too fat. I fuck around and catch an asthma attack. That's why I bust back. It don't faze me. When he drop, take his Glock and I'm Swayze. Celebrate my escape, solar block, what some weight. Lay back, I got some money to make. Motherfucker.
Can't be broke, nigga. Gotta make money.
Pushing the gas when my clocks blast. We was young and we was dumb, but we had heart. In the dark where we survived through the bad parts. Many dreams is what I had and plenty wishes. No hesitation in extermination of these snitches. Envious bitches.
Hey, and I'm gonna say this too, man. I'm so mad that society pit these two motherfuckers against each other. You know what I'm saying? I'm so mad that society pinned so many black kings against each other that was in the rap game, the industry, period. You know, I hated that. Because I feel like if that wasn't the case, motherfuckers would still be alive today. People would have still been able to raise their kids. You know what I'm saying? Biggie would have still been out here raising his kids. Tupac probably would have had some kids. You know what I'm saying? We never know. You feel me? So it kind of pisses me off to see that. But I'm happy they made a bad situation out of a good situation. I'm very happy that they did get the chance to link up and call each other brothers and really mess with each other and get to know each other for the time being. I'm glad that they came out the trenches, out the projects, because most people can't say that they did that. All niggas can say is, I know him. I know him. I knew him. I seen him before. That's all niggas can say, bro. That's why people hate so much, because what else they got? They ain't got nothing to lose. That's why motherfuckers be out here killing people. All this bullshit, man. Just bullshit. Black crime, bro. Why are we killing our own brothers, our own sisters because of jealousy, because of envy, because of hate when you can go get the same shit that they got? I don't get that. They came from nothing. You could do the same shit, bro. And nowadays, it's so fucking easy because we got social media. We got digital shit. It's so easy to get noticed and known now, bro. All you got to do is go viral. You got a record deal, bro. Like, let's be real. So, I'm just happy that they at least got to enjoy the fruits of their labor. Because a lot of people can't even say that. They die too quick to even enjoy their shit. Rest in peace, Pop Smoke. Barely 21 years old. King Von, so, man, it's crazy.
Still continue to pursue me. A couple of movies, now the whole world's trying to screw me. Even the cops tried to sue me. So what can I
shit,
do?
Shit, they was young too, 20.
Sipping 22's a brewing, now the media is trying to test me. Got the press asking questions, trying to stress me. Misery is all I see, that's my mind state. My history with the police to shake the crime rate. My main man had two strikes slip, got arrested and flipped. He screamed thug life and emptied the clip. Got tired of running from the police.
Yeah. That's why I'm saying, like, it make you just look at life different. You just gotta think about shit like that, bro. You can't come back from death. I don't wish death on nobody either. I mean, we all gonna die. That's why they say I'm living to die, dying to live. Like, man, this thing called life is fucking crazy. But if y'all enjoyed this, go ahead, like, comment, subscribe. I truly appreciate it, man. Catch me in my next video. Peace.